gauge here. So I got some virtual gauges here, and this is the DPF status. And you can see that it is on the edge of dirty. So this started up about 20 minutes ago. Let's put that fan on. Gotta have the lights on. My truck, I had a truck like this, T660 Kenworth 2010. This is a 2013. Some of the things I read about, you gotta have your lights on, air conditioning on, fan on, before you initiate the parked regen. Now I was hoping that it would do a passive regen, which is 50 miles an hour minimum. Driving down the road, it'll do a passive regen, but it didn't want to seem to initiate that. So when I got here to the customer, I'm in a parked regen. Whoops. Where did that go? Set up? I touched the wrong button. Gauges right there. So let's see what happens after about 20-30 minutes and see if this thing doesn't clean itself out. I have no idea. Right now it's at the auto regen yellow mode. Itself up, and it's designed to get up to, I don't know, somebody can correct me, I thought it was around 900 degrees. And what'll happen is, the turbo's over there, so what'll happen is, revs up, it gets exhaust gas temperatures up, and the exhaust gas pressure's up, pumps in, there's six cylinders, but there's a sixth injectors. There's a seventh injector that shoots fuel into behind the turbo, which goes back to the DPF filter, which is supposed to cook out all the soot that's collected. We'll come back in a few minutes after this is done and see if this goes back down to the clean, the little needle. I hope it does. We shall see. Stand by. Okay, so we can see here that the light has gone out. But it's still showing a hot exhaust, which is fine. That's what it's supposed to be showing. And we see the gauge on the filter gauge is showing it's clean. It's still going right now. It's still high revs, so I don't know what's... I hope it finishes pretty soon. I've heard stories like, don't stop it once it starts. The regen process. Right here for the moment. I gotta wait for the loader operator to come up and tell me to move up. And I'm kind of gambling or betting that this thing will be done by the time they're ready for me. And you can see it's getting terrible fuel economy while it's doing this thing. It uses a lot of fuel do a regen. This is why they recommend trying to do with things like when you get that light, get out on the road and drive. And that's why they want to put team drivers in all these trucks, so the truck spends more time driving than parked. Parking it and idling it are the death knell of these DPFs. That's diesel particulate filter, DPF. Here he comes, I think. Okay. Shoot. Once this thing starts, I hate to stop it, you know what I mean? Is he coming over here? All right. Go, 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 dude. Perfect. Idle in these trucks. If you must idle them, try to idle them up to around a minimum 900 RPMs. And low idle is terrible. Terrible for a lot of reasons. Bad for your cylinders, because the oil pressure maybe doesn't get all the way to the top of the cylinder. And you're running a dry cylinder at the top half of the cylinder, and just wearing them out. Plus, think about the exhaust gas temperatures and exhaust gas pressures are not hot enough and high enough to pump that stuff back through the turbo to get to clean your DPF, what's called a regen. while you're parked. Now, oftentimes we'll do an automatic regen. Say you're on your 10-hour break and you're low idling, and the DPF status will go dirty, and then we'll do an automatic regen for you. But if you can keep the RPMs up, maybe you're putting back cleaner soot, less soot, hotter soot that has a better chance of getting burned out during that automatic regen, or might not even need to do it. Until you get driving again, then you're going over 50 miles an hour, and it's doing what's called a passive regen on down the road. And you can extend the life for your filter, which is, last time I bought one was several years ago, was $6,000. It adds up. You gotta get them clean. You can only clean them twice, I believe. Somebody can correct me. Once you buy the $6,000 filter, and it may be more today, you can run it dirty. You know, you clean it like this, but after a certain amount of time, they have to be banked, cleaned, or whatever they want to do to it. You can only do that twice. Then you have to spend the money for another brand new filter again. So, it makes sense to make things last as long as possible to save a few bucks. And there you go. All right, so hopefully this thing is good to go for a few more months, or days, or whatever. That's the procedure, though. I should have showed you guys. You want to leave your lights on, fan on, air conditioning on, before you push that button. You push it for so many seconds, 1001, 1002, 1003, and it should automatically, if it needs it, it'll do it. You should be, okay, another thing is, when you end your day, you should be doing that. Set up this procedure and do it at the end of your driving day. If it doesn't do it, it doesn't need it.